It is a brief discussion on MCQ practice set 2. There are 10 questions here. Let us see one by one. This is our first question. A point of kink in the kink demand curve indicate. First, let us see how does this kink demand curve look like. Suppose this is a two-dimensional plot, then kink demand curve can look like this. It is not a very good plot, but to understand the concept, I think it is enough. So this is the demand curve. Here you can see this point is called kink because the demand curve changes its slope after this point. Whether you go above this point or below this point, the slope will change. So at this point, the price and the quantity remains rigid. So the answer, your answer will be price rigidity and quantity rigidity. So I will not explain the what actually the theory this actually means here, because it will be explained in a separate video. We will explain a theory of it, and for now it is important for you to remember that this kink point shows the price rigidity and quantity rigidity, and also remember a point that it was this hypothesis was given by Paul Sweezy, and it is related to oligopoly. So our correct option should be 1 and 2. So you can take this option. Let us come to the next question. So the next question is, improvement in BOP, that is balance of payment deficit, may be affected through import control, export promotion, foreign exchange control and devaluation. These all are correct options. Let me explain you one by one why this is so. First of all, BOP is what? BOP deficit arises when we have less foreign currency than we actually required, because for foreign goods and services we have to pay in foreign currency. So you need to have sufficient for foreign currency to pay for those foreign goods and services. If you do not have, that is, if you have less than what you have required, then you will have a balance of payment deficit. You will not be able to pay for those goods and services. So import control help by reducing the outflow of our currency from our country, because when we import, it means we purchase goods produced in other countries and we pay them in foreign currency. So if we have less import, we will have to pay less and BOP will be controlled. And inversely, export promotion will increase export. So by exporting, we will earn more foreign currency, and this will also help in decreasing the BOP deficit. And another is foreign exchange control. This is a separate theory on it. Foreign exchange control, this also helps in reducing BOP deficit by buying and selling of foreign currency. And devaluation helps our us by devaluing our currency. That is, after devaluation, the value of our currency decreases and value of foreign currency increases, due to which foreign goods become costlier and people purchase less of foreign good. That is, import decreases, and due to decrease in import, I have already tell you, BOP improves. That is, BOP deficit decreases. So this is the whole explanation. So the so for you, the correct option will be 1, 2, 3 and 4. So you can take this option. Let us come to the next question. This is one of the most controversial question of net GRP economics. Here you have nothing to explain. You have to simply memorize this, that the problem of relating to burden of public debt has been dealt by A.P. Lerner and A.H. Hansen. A.P. Lerner and A.H. Hansen is the correct option. So I have nothing to explain, but just to memorize this, because there are always something which you need to memorize. Now let us come to next question. The next question is, foreign policy relate to government decision in respect of Actually, whatever government do related to money, that is spending or borrowing anything, this is fiscal policy. And whatever RBI do for economy is monetary policy. So this is the simple differentiation. So here it is very clear that these all stuffs are done by government. Taxation and tax rate are imposed by government. This is a fiscal measure. Government spending also a fiscal measure. Government borrowing or government lending also is fiscal measure. And public debt, it is also done by government. So it is also a fiscal measure. So the option for you here is all of above. Let us come to the next question. So our next question is, SDI is entrusted with reference to. The correct options are here. I think you should memorize. Everything is not understood. Something need to be memorized. So here you have to memorize that there are three components in SDI. First is life expectancy. Second is real GDP. And third is enrollment ratio. So enrollment ratio is not given here. So these options are not true. So our option is only 1 and 2. So only 1 and 2 are correct. You can tick this option. Let us come to the next question. Our next question is, the doctrine of unbalanced growth was propounded by. Here again you need to memorize this. The option are Hirschman and Singer. Regner Nagy is related to balanced growth, so you need to remember that he is related to balanced growth, and these two persons are related to unbalanced growth. So our option is 1 and 3. That is 1 and 3. This is the correct option. Now let us come to the next question. Here it has been asked, Harrod-Domar model of economic growth is based upon. So in Harrod-Domar model, there are three types of growth. Two are given here, and the third one is not given here. It is warranted rate of growth and the natural rate of growth, and the one more is the actual rate of growth. So actual rate of growth is not given here. So we have only 1 and 4 are correct. These are not something in Harrod-Domar model. So these are the component. Investment is the part of Harrod-Domar model. Productivity is also a part of Harrod-Domar model. But the growth rate he talks about is warranted growth rate, natural growth rate, and the actual growth rate. So our option is 1 and 4. This is the correct option. Let us go to the next. Here in Keynesian system, speculative demand for money arises because of uncertainty of future interest rate. It is correct option, because in the Keynesian system, money can be used either for transaction or for purchasing bond. So the bond and interest rate are related. So why we purchase bond, purchase or sell bond due to uncertainty of interest rate in future. So speculative demand for money will depend on the uncertainty of interest rate in future. And similarly, this, since interest rate and bond prices are related, this is also a relationship between change in the interest rate and bond prices. So you have to memorize that the speculative demand of money is related to rate of interest, that is future rate of interest, and the bond prices. And the bond prices and the interest rates are inversely related. If the bond prices increases, interest rate is lower, and bond prices is lower, then interest rate is higher. This is a separate theory in Keynesian system. We will explain in a separate video about this. So here our option is again 1 and 4. This is our correct option. Let us come to the next question. This is very simple question. According to Milton Friedman, theory of permanent component of consumption expenditure depends on permanent income alone. So here is the option is permanent income alone. The component of permanent component of consumption expenditure depends on only permanent income. So you have to memorize that. It is the Milton Friedman's theory of permanent income hypothesis. So our option here is only 3 is correct. So you can tick this option. Let us come to the next question. So our next question is, which of the following committee are related to poetry estimation in India? So whatever you can see, these all committees are related to poetry estimation in India. You have to also remember their chronology. This can also be asked in the examination. So this is a very important question for you, and you must know the first. You need to memorize the chronology, and you need to remember that these are related to poetry estimation in India, and there are also other concepts which are related to poetry estimation. You have to also learn that. We will talk about that later on. For now, this was a brief discussion, and it ends here. So here our correct option should be 1, 2, 3, and 4. We will see in our next practice set.